once as a child, you were frightened by a huge smart man. Though the dog was called Mary's best friend by now, you have hated and feared dogs all your life. One night, as you lie in a lonely room in a stone hut on the moors, you are awakened by a sound in the distance.
I'm
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You know, we ain't gonna go like another fool to the fish TV show. You know. Yes, I see the sleep of death. spilled moment on the dolphin's floor. I won't lend another hand to the warm girl of Hanoi. Don't deplete my oxygen for the guy who's turning blue. But ask me and I'll do anything for you. Whenever I think of you, it only makes me feel sad. Whenever I think of you, the best friend I ever had, before I gave it all up for nothing. Well, I lied and I cheated, and it made me feel bad. Made me feel guilty for not being true. Or the months I spent trying for a way to explain. In the end, all I could do was turn my head in shame. Never I think of you. Oh, darling, it makes me feel sad. Cause you deserve better. And once I was it, somehow my good intentions just got away. So I can't spare a moment on the dog-faced boy. I won't lend another hand to the warm girl of Hanoi. Don't deplete my oxygen for the guy who's turning blue. But ask me and I'll do anything for you.
Thank you. exceptions until today. Many people have been cat fanciers. You are such a person. Your cat is a big, beautiful black animal. His appearance as much like a panther as a cat. Your pet is a very friendly one. Each day as you come home from work, he shows you his affection by purring and rubbing his sleek fur against your legs as you reach down to scratch his head. Until one day...
Thank you. I'm gonna go get some more. Thank you.
But like it or not, something always seems to go wrong. Sometimes people build you up just so they can knock you down. Sometimes they don't have you there because they need someone around. I should receive invitations for tea. Perhaps you laugh and you'll make them all smile. Or maybe you'll join them because it had to be. Perhaps you'll forget that you forgot for a while.
Birds of a feather, a flocking outside. Birds of a feather, a flocking outside. Birds of a feather, a flocking outside.
Jimmy's sitting at his computer and he's working on his math homework. The thesis that he's writing is a load of shit, but we're very glad he finally finished it. He's finishing it right now. He's finishing the thesis. Anyways, working on his math homework, and you know, he's sitting in his little suburban house, and next to him is his beautiful cat. His cat is a beautiful his cat.
Your cat is a big beautiful black man.
This cat is a big beautiful black animal, more like a panther than a cat. Anyway, this cat, I'm gonna get right to the point here at the beginning here, is that this cat is named Buster Nupa! I gotta lead up to that. Anyway, so Jimmy's sitting in his house, he's petting Buster Nupa, and he's contemplating digits and animals and the beautiful kingdom of numbers, numerology, and the natural kingdom. And you know, as he's sitting there, he starts to have a moment where suddenly it all starts to make sense. He's getting messages from the beyond, and there's a click happening, and he suddenly can see clearly. He decides to make his mind blank, surrender to the flow, put his blank space where his mind could be. And in this moment, Jimmy starts to see images floating in front of his face. And the first thing that he sees, he sort of sees a number. He sees lines going like this. It's kind of a triangle of a line. And it's the number 4. And he says, 4. This is something, this means something to me. 4, there's 4 seasons. There's northwest, you know, southeast, 4. And then suddenly he starts, the lines of the 4 start to move. And suddenly they become a quadrant. A four-sided figure, which is a square. And he thinks, oh, a 4, a square. I'm getting this. The message is coming into my mind. I see something. I see a 4. I see a square. It means something. And then he sees an image in his mind, and mark this, he sees four squares and four circles. He doesn't know what this all means, but he really feels like the great spirit, whether it's Icarus or the spirit of his second name, Icarus's other name, which is Holy Blankenstein, because he believes in a blanket. Icarus has two names. It's almost like Icarus is speaking. Holy Blankenstein is speaking to Jimmy. He's encouraging him that he's almost onto this thing. And he's like saying, Jimmy, it's like, you're getting there, Jimmy. He's like, yeah. You hear the voice of Icarus, the voice of Holy Blankenstein saying, yeah, like, yeah, Jimmy, you're there it is. That's it. That's the voice. He sees the four, he sees the square, the seasons, and on the fourth day, you know, God made light and divided time, and because sunshine, you know, sunlight and all that. Just when he thinks he's getting it, the force starts to change. It morphs. It morphs between his before his eyes. Suddenly, it looks like a six now. He can't figure out why. It becomes a six. And suddenly he says, oh my God, a square with six surfaces is a cube. He sees a cube floating. And Holy Blankenstein, Icarus is like, you're almost there, Jimmy. You're like, uh-huh. You're almost there, Jimmy. Uh-huh. That's it. There's the voice of Icarus saying, you're figuring this out. It's a four, a square, a quadrangle with six faces is a cube. The cube is floating before his eyes. Suddenly, in a flash, the six-sided cube splits into nine, and he sees nine cubes in front of him. He's like, oh my God, whoa! The six has become a nine. And he says, if six were nine, if the mountains crumbled into the sea, let it be! It is me! And he starts thinking about how much he likes Jimi Hendrix, and since his mind isn't blank anymore, the nine cubes suddenly collapse back into one cube. It's one cube again. And he thinks, have I lost it? I'm gonna put a blank space where my mind can be. I surrender to the flow. Oh. He hears the voice of Icarus. It's almost like Icarus is laughing at him. Or with him. Oh, holy Blankenstein. Holy Blankenstein and Icarus create many, its many spirits melded into one. We call it the spirit of we, the spirit of togetherness. Hello. How are you? We hope you're having a good time. It's not us, it's Blankenstein and Icarus together. I don't know. He's got it. The six, the four, he's like 46, that's it? 46 days, what is it? 46 what? Right then, the edges of the cube begin to light up. They turn red and green. They're bright fluorescent colors on the edge. And he starts counting them. He's like, oh my God. A cube has eight vertices. Vertices? The lines, the vertices. There's eight straight lines on the edge of a cube. And at that point, the cube collapses. It becomes an eight. It's like, oh my God, eight edges to a cube. Eight. And as he's stuck at the eight, he's like, four, six, eight. What is this? At this point, the voice of Holy Blankenstein Icarus has become like a wicka 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 sound. It's driving him crazy. Wicka wicka wicka. Then the eight starts to turn sideways, and it becomes the sign for infinity. That's it. 4, 6, 8 is infinity. It's everything. He says out loud, it's everything. But as soon as he says the word everything, it's like he lost it again. Here's a flash. A flash. A flash of light. And it becomes a zero. A circle. It's like, oh my God, I'm back to the four circles and the four squares, but now it's a zero. I don't understand that. I can't comprehend what this number is all about. 4, 6, 8, 0. But there's a zero in front of him. He thinks nothing. Nothing, zero, emptiness, nothing. And that's when it hits him. Once he completely thinks of emptiness, it all becomes clear. At that moment, the circle begins to tilt backwards, and it lands on a grid, which is a plane, and the circle is on the grid. And suddenly he realizes so clearly the obvious truth that it's becoming a circle, and that if you vary the X, Y, and Z terms, that would describe a circle of radius one, the radius being the hypotenuse of the X, Y, and Z coordinates. And he realizes that the X and Y terms in the square distance from the two units of the origin, and he remembers that the square root of XX plus YY is the distance from the origin. So each of the circles is centered two units from the origin, obviously. And as XY sweep out of their range of being, the two units away from the origin, there's a vertical circle. Can you see it? At each point on the circle. And those vertical circles sweep out from the circle and it becomes a donut. It's a torus. It's a donut. Oh my God. At that moment, behind the donut, the six reappears and he realizes that insects have six legs and that the back of a turtle shell has a hexagon in the center. Six. Hexagon. Donuts. Donuts touching turtles. Turtles touching donuts. It's the very stuff the universe is made of. You see it? Do you see it? Donuts touching turtles. It was there all along. It was in everything. Suddenly the square appears again. The square becomes a cube. And the cube starts to tilt sideways. It's a rhombus. The cube is a rhombus. The ninth cube. Oh my God, says Jimmy, I get it. And now I know exactly what Fish is gonna play for Halloween. Duh! How could I have not seen it? The number of hits that they've been giving us, how could I have not seen it? The Animal Kingdom, the Numerical Kingdom, turtles with six-sided hexagons on their backs, hepapod insects, come on! 40th anniversary, 50th anniversary, you know what I'm talking about. Okay. So, listen, he's so excited, he blows off the homework. He's so excited. The whole time it's been pouring rain outside. It's almost like the universe is listening to his realization. The sun is starting to peek through the clouds, through his window. The silver light is shining on his desktop. And he says, that's it. I'm going to post on my Instagram right now. And I am not kidding. Jimmy is going to post on his Instagram. Which he gives him that. Oh yeah. Jimmy Poster Dad. Right now, exactly what the Fish Halloween album is tomorrow. He starts typing. He's posting it. There he goes. He's sitting down. He's typing what the Halloween album is on Jimmy Poster Dad Instagram. Now, you're probably thinking, you're fucking with me because every year you guys fuck with us. So if I say he's actually writing right now what we're playing, clearly he isn't because I would never say that. But that's how we're fucking with you this year. We're telling you what we're playing on Halloween. It's on Jimmy Poster Dad Instagram right now. He is typing. There he goes. He's typing furiously. I can see him in my mind's eye. But all of a sudden, oh, there's a knock on the door. It's crushing my vibe. Who is it? Ah, shit. Hold on. He puts down the typer. He turns around. He sees through the crack of the door. His father? Oh, man. Look, the storm's gone. Jimmy?
Bad news.
What is it, Dad?
It's like you're the petite chef.
Jennifer.
Thank you.
who leaned against the wall, ignoring me. He was on his way to see the king. Of Potter Target as he tried to find show from Esperino underneath his boogie. Said there was a place where we should go. So he led me through the forest to the edge of a lagoon, on which we wandered till we reached a bubbly spring. The man grew very quiet as we stood there. He lifted up his visor and he turned to me in began to say, from doing things where people don't do. See, it was one side of two. His name was Rutherford the Brave, and he was on a quest to save his people from the fate that lay before them. Their clumsy end was perilously near. The lizards would be saved, he said, and they could be enlightened by the writings of the humming friendly book. All of Prussia, only one existed, and Wilson had declared that any person who possessed it was a crook. He said, I come from the land of darkness. Of eternal joy and never-ending splendor. The trick was to surrender to the flow. We walked along beneath the moon. He led us through the bush till soon we saw before our eyes a raging river. He said we can swim it if we try. And saying this, the knight dove in, forgetting that his suit of arms would show the way down, and so he sunk. And as his body disappeared before me, I bowed my head aside, remembered all the thoughts that he had. Said, I come from the land of darkness. Oh,
Saw the northern lights, never really heard of cluster flies.
on the stars.
Thank you.
your foolish bread, I'll cast the final vote. The feelings you've been waiting for are clawing through your skin. So if you look above, you'll see the vultures moving.
Thank you. was fucking amazing.
I hate Tom Sawyer.
What was that? What the fuck was that anyway? I do know what time signature is playing. He's either playing it 4680 or 10:31:21. Because I think that was the. So I said you were playing. Well, we've got time for this. It's been a great night. Getting a little sad here. I don't want to leave. Thank you. Power.